So students, today we are going to deal with the new topic, which is capacitance of a conductor. Suppose a capacitor is there, or a conductor is there, which is spherical in shape, you can see. Now when the plus Q charge is given to this capacitor or spherical conductor, that charge will reside only on its outer surface. Because of this charge, the potential will be developed on its surface, which we can write 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q by r. So now, from the basic definition of capacitance, the capacitance C that is given by Q by V. This Q as it is. Now from first equation we can substitute the value of V, which is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught R into Q. Q, Q cancel. And final result you will obtain, that is C equals to 4 pi epsilon naught R. So that is the formula of capacitance of a spherical capacitor. Remember that this capacitance of the capacitor that depends on some parameters. First one is the size R. Second one, it depends on the medium. So if we plot the graph between R size and capacitance, it will be a straight line passing through origin, C proportional to R. Instead of that, if we plot the graph between capacitance and 1 by R, it will be a rectangular hyperbola like this. So now, again, I would like to repeat. Capacitance, what is that? Capacitance is the capacity to store charge by a conductor. Now, so many types of capacitors are there. Spherical, cylindrical, or parallel plate capacitor. Here, we are going to derive the expression of capacitance of a spherical capacitor. So, this is a spherical capacitor or a conductor. Now when Q charge is given to this capacitor, it will reside only on its outer surface. Due to that, the potential will increase. That potential we can write as V equals to Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught. Now substituting this value, C equals to Q by V formula, you will get C equals to 4 pi epsilon naught R. My dear students, we are going to deal with the principle of capacitance. For that, we have a conductor. That conductor has positive charge, you can see, and let the potential of this conductor is V and its capacitance is C. So in general, if it is have charge Q, the formula C will be Q by V. Now if we want to increase this capacitance, the only way is to decrease the electric potential. To do so, we will bring an identical conducting plate in front of it. Now due to induction, the negative charge will appear, will induce on the left side of the sheet B, and on the right side the positive charge will be induced. Now, due to this negative and positive charge, there is no effect on this potential of this plate A. But when we ground this, when we earth this plate, due to earthing, electrons, they will come out of the ground and they will neutralize this positive charge. So as soon as this positive charge is neutralized, only negative charge is present on this side of plate B. Due to that, this potential of plate A will decrease by a certain amount. So potential between the plates will decrease, so capacitance will increase. So this is the basic principle of capacitance. Again, I would like to revise this. See, I am repeating this. Why we need this principle? Suppose we want to increase the capacitance of a conductor. There is only one way to increase its size. Suppose we want to increase the capacitance without increasing its size. So there is only one way. Now listen carefully. Capacitance of a conductor A can be increased by bringing an identical uncharged grounded conductor very closer to it. Again, I am repeating. Capacitance of a conductor can be increased without increasing its size just by bringing an identical grounded plate very closer to it, or grounded conductor. So my dear students, now we are going to deal with the next topic, which is capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor. Now over here, there are two plates. You can see this is plate A, which is positively charged, and surface charge density is plus sigma. In front of that, another plate is there which is negatively charged. You can see these green lines that shows electric field lines, and this electric field between the plates, that is uniform electric field, has magnitude E. The distance between these two plates, you can see, is D. And let the potential difference between the plates is V. Plus Q charge is on the first sheet, minus Q charge is induced on the another sheet. So if I want to derive the expression of capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor, first of all, the basic formula of capacitance, C equals to Q by V. Second, electric potential between the plates can be written as electric field intensity into D. Now electric field intensity between the plates, that will be because of the first sheet, blue sheet, and because of second, yellow sheet. In magnitude, that will be sigma upon 2 epsilon naught because of first sheet, sigma upon 2 epsilon naught because of second sheet. So this is 2 sigma upon 2 epsilon naught, which is finally sigma by epsilon naught. Now as we know, sigma is surface charge density, written as Q by A, charge per unit area. So it is Q upon A epsilon naught. Now electric field intensity, we will substitute this value in the formula of potential, that is Q by A epsilon naught into D. Now this formula we are going to put in equation number 1. So finally, C, that is Q divided by Q D upon A epsilon naught. Now this Q, Q cancel, and the final expression of electric capacitance, that is A epsilon naught by D. So that is the expression of electric potential, C equals to A epsilon naught by D, capacitance. Now see here, in board examination so many times this question is asked, that write the factors on which capacitance of a capacitor depends, parallel plate capacitor. So first thing is, this capacitance depends on the area of each plate. Second, the capacitance that depends on the distance between the plates. And the third one is, this capacitance depends on the medium present between the plates. So you can see there are three factors on which capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor depend. Okay, so the next topic which we are going to start, that is series combination of the capacitor. Remember students, this series combination of the capacitor, that is similar to the combination of resistors which you have already studied in 10th standard. So over here, suppose there are three capacitors. Remember that this is the symbol of a parallel plate capacitor. These two vertical lines, between the vertical lines, parallel lines, there is a gap. This is the symbol of parallel plate capacitor. So let there are three parallel plate capacitors having capacitance C1, C2 and C3. When these capacitors are connected with a cell or a battery of voltage V, suppose Q charge is supplied by the cell, because they are connected in series, the same charge will appear on each capacitor Q, Q and Q. But the potential difference across the ends of each capacitor will be same, Q, V1, V2 and V3. So now what will be the definition of series combination of capacitor? Whenever two or more than two capacitors, they are connected in such a way that charge on each capacitor is same. So combination is said to be series combination. Now over here, again through this diagram, you people can see Q charge is supplied by this battery, this plus Q, positive charge will appear on the first plate of C1. You can see plus Q. Due to induction on the opposite plate, minus charge will be developed, minus Q, and so on. It will be developed plus Q on C2, then minus Q, plus Q, minus Q, you can see. Now our target is to find the capacitance of this combination, total capacitance or equivalent capacitance. So let the potential difference between the terminals of first capacitor, that is C1, you can see this is V1. Potential difference between the plates or between the terminals of capacitance C1 is V1. For second capacitor, that is V2. For the third capacitor, it is V3. So the total potential, we can write V equals to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Now, as we know, the potential V is given by Q by C. Similarly, V1, we can write Q upon C1, V2 as Q by C2. V3 as Q by C3. So all these three values of V1, V2, V3, we are going to substitute in this expression, V equals to V1 plus V2 plus V3. So when we will substitute, you will get Q by C1 plus Q by C2 plus Q by C3. Now over here you will find q as constant. So 1 upon c1 plus 1 upon c2 plus 1 upon c3, that is v. So thereafter we can follow by this step. Q by c equals to q upon c1, q by c2 plus q by c3. So over here you can see q is common, will cancel, and finally what you will have, 1 upon c equals to 1 upon c1 plus 1 upon c2 plus 1 upon c3. If suppose n number of capacitors are connected in series, this addition will go up to n terms plus 1 upon cn. So we can say the reciprocal of the effective capacitance is the sum of reciprocal of the individual capacitance. And remember that whenever we connect capacitors in series, then the equivalent capacitance, value of equivalent capacitance, is minimum, and it is less than that of the capacitor which has the least value of the capacitance. And if suppose two capacitors are there in series, suppose two capacitors are there and these are connected in series, so equivalent capacitance can be written as C1 C2 upon C1 plus C2. So that's all for this topic. So now students, we are going to deal with the next topic, which is the parallel combination of the capacitors. Now suppose there are three capacitors having capacitance C1, C2 and C3. As you can see in the figure, first capacitor has capacitance C1, second is having capacitance C2 and third is having capacitance C3. The first plate of C1, C2 and C3 is combinedly connected to point A, and second plate of all three capacitors is connected at point B. Now these two points, again they are connected to a cell of potential difference V. It means potential difference between the plates of each capacitor, that is same V. So the combination is said to be parallel combination. Remember that how we'll define the parallel combination: when two or more than two capacitors, they are connected in such a way that potential difference between the plates of each capacitor is same, the combination is said to be parallel combination. Now over here, if suppose a charge Q is supplied by the cell, this charge Q will be distributed among C1, C2 and C3. So first capacitor suppose is holding a charge Q1, second capacitor is holding charge Q2, and third capacitor is holding charge Q3. So from the law of conservation of charge, we can write total charge Q equals to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. Now from the basic definition, we can write Q1 as C1V, Q2 as C2V, Q3 as C3V, and Q equals to CV. Now all these values we are going to substitute in this equation number 1. So when we substitute the value of Q, we will get CV. Instead of Q1, we will get C1V, then C2V, and then C3V. So when we will take the common V over here, so we will get V C1 plus C2 plus C3. Now you can see V, V cancel. So finally the result is C equals to C1 plus C2 plus C3. So it means whenever the capacitors are connected in parallel, the equivalent capacitance is given by the algebraic sum of all the capacitance, C equals to C1 plus C2 plus C3 up to Cn. Remember that the value of equivalent capacitance in series combination is more than that of the capacitance which is present in the combination. Its value is maximum, more than that, the highest value of the capacitance present in the combination. Now students, next topic that we are going to deal with is energy stored in a capacitor. Remember that this derivation which we are going to do is valid for any type of the capacitor, whether it is a parallel plate capacitor, you can see in front of the screen, and the potential difference between the plates of the capacitor is V. The charge on first sheet is plus Q, the charge on the yellow sheet is minus Q, and surface charge density is plus sigma and minus sigma respectively. So students, suppose there is a conductor of radius R. When Q charge is given to this conductor, it will be uniformly distributed on its surface and it will increase the potential of the conductor. So we can write Q equals to CV. So the value of V will be Q by C. Let this is equation number one. Now further, suppose more amount of charge dQ we want to give to this conductor, we have to do work. So that is stored as their energy, electrostatic potential energy. Now over here, the small amount of work done to give charge dQ to the conductor, that is written as dQ into V. Now we will substitute the value of V, which is Q by C. Now if I want to calculate the total amount of work done, suppose the minimum charge given to capacitor is 0 and maximum charge which is given to capacitor is Q. So we'll integrate that. So integrating this above equation from the proper limits, we can write 0 to capital Q, then Q dQ. Integration of Q, that is Q square by 2. Now if we write the value of upper and lower limit, it is going to be Q square upon 2C. So students, the expression of energy stored in capacitor is Q square by 2C. This Q square by 2C, we can write some more other expressions for the same energy. See, we know Q equals to CV, so it will be C square V square upon 2C. 1C cancel, so formula will be half of CV square. Or one more formula you can write, we can write it as CV into V. So CV is Q, so it will be half of QV. What is the significance of this half? Significance of half is that it shows that 50% amount of work done is stored only as energy and 50% is wasted. Wasted in the sense 50% amount of work is done to charge the capacitor and 50% is stored as energy. So 50% of amount of work done is wasted as heat energy. My dear students, now we are going to deal with the next topic, which is energy density. First of all, we will define the energy density. Remember that the energy density, that is denoted by U subscript D, which is energy stored per unit volume of a capacitor or a conductor. So energy stored per unit volume of a conductor or a capacitor, that is defined as its energy density. Now we are going to derive the expression of energy density. So let this is equation number one. As we know, the energy stored in a capacitor is half of C V square. Remember that this V is for potential, sorry, volume, and this V is for potential difference between the plates. So let this is equation number two. Now volume of a parallel plate capacitor will be product of area and volume, sorry, distance. So now over here, if we substitute the value of energy density, you will find half of CV square divided by A into D. As we know, capacitance is A epsilon naught by D. So the energy density formula will be half of A epsilon naught by D, then again A, then V square and D. A cancel. So finally it is half of epsilon naught V square by D square. Moreover, the energy density expression is given by half of epsilon naught E square. So the formula of energy density is half of epsilon naught E square. So finally, we found the formula of energy density, that is half of epsilon naught E square. And we can say energy stored in a capacitor, it is in form of electric field. Remember this thing. For one mark question or fill in the blanks, energy stored in a capacitor, it is always in form of electric field. Now suppose sometimes so many capacitors are connected in combination, and if they want total energy, so total stored energy we can find by a simple method of addition of energies stored in individual capacitors. So that's all for this topic, and we will continue with the next topic in the coming lectures. Thank you. Best of luck.